Hey, what's going on out there? I'm Sean Devine. Hope you all are doing well. In this tutorial, we are going to take a deep dive into the all new Logic Pro 11 stem splitter. This is arguably the most interesting new feature in this latest version. It promises a lot of power on paper to enhance your mixing and mastering workflow, opens up a lot of new possibilities in terms of producing and remixing. But I gotta tell you, I've been a little bit skeptical about this type of tech in the past. Generally, the results just don't do what they promise, and there's a lot of artifacts, and it just hasn't really been that useful to me previously. However, this stem splitter in Logic Pro 11 has pleasantly surprised me quite a bit by the capabilities. So let's go ahead and dive in. All right, so to access the stem splitter in Logic Pro 11, we're simply going to right-click on our audio region, and we're going to click Stem Splitter. It's just a group of tracks that can be now separated from our two-track or our single wave file into these stems, which can be your vocal stem, your drum stem, your bass stem, and an other stem in the case of Stem Splitter. So you can select these over here, whichever ones you want to separate, and then we'll just click Split down here. It will create a track stack and mute that single wave file. So we have our vocal, drum, bass, and other. So let's go ahead and just play it back. This is the full mix. Feel I've been gone for a minute, about time I hop back in it. They try to pull my energy from everything that mattered to me. It's time to sell my soul free. Let's take a listen to these in isolation, starting with the other, which is going to be our music and our instrument tracks. Okay, how about bass? Not bad. How about our drums? That's pretty impressive. Very clean separation with the kick and the snare, even the cymbals there. Finally, the vocals, what I'm most interested in. I'm going to go more towards the verse over here. And let's see. Will you come on now? I'm about to drop up in a verse and curse and say nothing that could really matter. Just a pitter-patter on the window panel. I'm the kid who tries to escape with a vape. Mom and dad downstairs screaming, get up out my face. No role models. Try to find purpose in a whiskey bottle in the pill bliss so I don't feel this. Gotta get numb just to get through a day. Gotta think twice about it. So listening to it a cappella, yes, there are some imperfections. But in the context of separating these, let's say in my case, I'll get single waves to do mastering, and there may be a case where the vocal is just a little bit too loud or a little bit too quiet, and I want to adjust that, but I can't. So in this case, you know, if you don't have something like Ozone, this opens up that capability for you. So let's just say, again, the vocal was a little bit too loud in the mix, and I wanted to bring this down, you know, like a dB. I'm about to drop up in a verse and curse and say nothing that could really matter. Just a pitter patter on the window panel. I'm the kid who tries to escape with the vape. Mom and dad downstairs screaming, get up out my face. No role models. Try to find purpose in a whiskey bottle in the pill bliss so I don't feel this. Gotta get white boy from the south, hip hop and my blood, hoop dreams, first love. Mom praying over me and my brother, an everyday struggle to keep God first and then want the worst for you. So taking the vocal out and just isolating the instrument tracks, that's really useful too, because then you could, you know, maybe send all this to its own bus without affecting the vocal. I like the idea of that. You know, also if we wanted to come in here and just kiss the vocal with a compressor a little bit, not affect the rest of our music. Feel I've been gone for a minute, about time I hop back in it. They try to pull my energy from everything that mattered to me. It's time to set my soul free, yeah. Yeah, you can't tell me nothing. You best stand for something when it comes crashing down. Maybe this is something that they can build on in the future, but I think it would be great to be able to separate individual drum elements in, you know, a drum stem, not necessarily just by transient, but being able to utilize that AI to remove and isolate like the kick, the snare, you know, the hi-hat. Sometimes I'll use drum loops, or a producer will send me a drum loop, and I don't have control over some of those individual elements without the stems. So that might be something that, again, maybe they can develop further in the future. All right, y'all. So that is the new stem splitter in Logic Pro 11. I think this is going to be an invaluable and practical tool for mixing and mastering engineers, for producers, for remixers. For me personally, again, just being able to utilize this in mastering outside of some of the other plugins I have, just stock in Logic Pro, that is pretty great. And again, as a producer, being able to maybe go back into some of my old production that I don't have the sessions for and being able to pull out some of these stems, that's really promising to me. Now, obviously, it's not perfect when you listen to this in isolation. However, again, I think for practical purposes and in the context of a mix, or if you're doing mastering, this is still very useful. So let me know what you think about Stem Splitter. I know some of you may still be on the fence about updating to Logic Pro 11. You're on Logic Pro 10 and you don't want to mess up compatibility and your old sessions. I just put up a video on how to install Logic Pro 11 and Logic Pro 10 or previous versions on the same Mac. So I'll put a link to that if you want to check it out. But let me know what you think about the Stem Splitter in Logic Pro 11. Hope this video was helpful. Please like, subscribe, and consider sharing. Hit that notification bell for more, and we'll talk to you soon.